The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text 6-8, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in the summer of 1966 in New York.
Bhutanam Sarupi Sam Prakritim Sam Adhishaya Sambhavami Atamaya. Now, Lord Sri Krishna is describing how he incarnates himself. For the benefit of conditioned souls in the material world, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he descends. The Sanskrit word is avatar, 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 avataram. Avataram means who comes from higher plane down to this material world. He is called avatar. So sometimes Lord Sri Krishna comes himself and sometimes he sends his representative also for deliverance of the conditioned soul. Now the principal religion of the world, Hindu religion, Muslim religion, Christian religion, and Buddha religion, most of them believe some supreme authority or personality coming down from the kingdom of God. Just like in your Christian religion, Lord Jesus Christ, he claimed to be the Son of God and coming from the kingdom of God to reclaim it. So this claim of Lord Jesus Christ, we admit, we the followers of Bhagavad Gita, we admit this claim. So there is no difference of opinion between the followers of Hindu religion and Christian religion. In details there may be, according to country, climate and people, in details there may be difference. But that does not make any material difference. So far, devotional service is concerned. Now there are several items for offering devotional service to the Lord. They are called Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Satyam, Atma Vivedanam. These are nine. Now here in this room, we are performing the process of Sravanam and Kirtanam. Just like we chanted Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. This is reciprocation of Sravanam and Kirtanam, hearing and chanting. Chanted, you heard, and you chanted, I heard. Reciprocation. So this is these two methods as the first method in devotional service. Savanam Kirtanam. And what about hearing and chanting? Now Vishnu. Vishnu means the Supreme Lord. Vishnu. Not any other thing. If we may chanting and hearing in some other subject matter, no, that is not true. We have to hear and chant about Vishnu, the Supreme Lord. Similarly, Saranam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, meditation, if you meditate upon the Supreme Lord, that is also bhakti, devotional service, Smaranam. Sarvam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasivanam Archanam Archanam Temple worship. Even in your country there is no temple worship. In our India there is temple. There are thousands and thousands of temples in India. And in Vrindavan, where my residence headquarters is, Vrindavan, it is a small city, about 50,000 people living there. But you'll be surprised to know there are 5,000 temples. For 50,000 people, there are 5,000 temples in one small city. And out of that, there are about dozens very big temples, very just like four, very big temples. So, temple worship is very popular in India. Similarly, you have got your charges here, that is Vandana. Vandana. Vandana means offering prayer. You also offer prayer to the Supreme Lord. So that is also accepted for devotion and service. But Muslims also, they go to the mosque and offer prayer to Allah. So, practically, and in Buddhism, Lord Buddha is accepted as incarnation of Krishna in Srimad Bhagavatam. So we also, Hindus, we worship Lord Buddha as incarnation of God. There is a very nice verse recited by one great poet, Vaishnava poet. He'll be glad to hear and recite it. Nimnati jagravidheraha sthuti jatam sadaya vidaya darshita pasighatam kesava dhrita buddha sariram jaya jagadisa hare jaya jagadisa hare. The purpose of this verse is, oh Lord Krishna, you have assumed the form of Lord Buddha, taking compassion on the poor animals. Because Lord Buddha's preaching was to stop animal killing, ahimsa, non-violence. His main objective was to stop animal killing. So similarly, some higher kingdom, and the kingdom of God, there is exactly the kingdom of God. We have got this information from the Bhagavad Gita. Parastasma subhava anya. And there is another nature, just like you have got a vision of this nature. You find this wall in the sky, blue, beyond the sky. Millions and millions miles away, there is another star. Parastatma, Anna, there is another nature, which is called Sanatana. You find in this Bhagavad Gita as you make progress. That is called Sanatana nature. Sanatana means that nature never annihilates. This nature, this material nature, it is manifested at a certain time and it remains for a certain period and then the whole thing is dissolved. Again, bhutya bhutta previyate, it is manifested and again dissolved and in the spiritual star. That is the function of this material nature. And beyond this material nature, there is another nature, superior nature, which is called the kingdom of God. Sanatana, eternal. Yes. So, from that eternal nature, all these, either God or representative of God or incarnation of God, they come down at times. When there is necessity, just like the other day I explained to you, just like there is scheduled time of the appearance of the sun. In America, just like at 4:30 in the morning, you find the sun rising. Scheduled time. And again, 24 hours after, you find the same sun rising. In every country, there is a scheduled time of the sun rising. Similarly, there are innumerable universes in the sky. This is one of the universes which you are seeing. There are innumerable universes. So, in one of the universes, there is some incarnation of the principle of God always there. And there is a scheduled time, just like the sun appears and disappears, exterior sun disappears means it goes out of our sight. It does not mean some sun stop to exist. No. Sun is always in the sky. It is simply in our vision, just like so many cars are passing. One car is coming, you do not see which car is coming. When it is in my front, I see the car. And again, when it is gone out of my sight, I don't see. So my don't seeing, because I do not see the car, that does not mean it is not there. Similarly, the incarnation of God, God Himself, or His representative, Son, because just like if we have to do some business seriously, we send our very responsible man to confront that. Similarly, for the deliverance of the fallen souls here in this material world, sometimes the Supreme Lord Krishna comes, sometimes sends his very confidential and representative to declare. The mission is the same. The mission is the same to reclaim the fallen souls. To reclaim the fallen souls. God is very compassionate to see our misery here. We do not know. We have forgotten what that, although we are in misery, we are trying to adjust the misery. We are trying to adjust misery. But we are part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. Therefore, we are not meant for all this misery. We must know it. We are not meant for all this misery. But we have voluntarily accepted this material misery. And what are these miseries? They are called Adhyaptik, Adhibhautik, and Adhidaivik. Adhyaptik means misery passing into this body and mind. Just like today we are feeling too hot. Why? Due to this body. And next moment I can feel not very happy. My mind is disturbed. So there are miseries due to this body and due to the mind. This is called Adhyaptik. And then again, Adhibhautik. Some other living entity, just like here, you are hearing the barking of the dog, throw all it. There is some kind of disturbance. So such kind of misery offered by other living beings is called Adhibhautik. We have got so many miseries. And then Adhidaivik. Daivik means that misery is offered by the supernatural thought. Just like there is earthquake, famine, pestilence, war. So, we are always, there are three headings of misery. And we are suffering either from the three all or at least one. There must be. This is the nature of our life in this material existence. But we are trying to make a solution of it. That is our struggle for existence. But that solution cannot be made by our teeny brain. That solution can be made only when we get to the center of Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Therefore, the Lord comes himself. Just to convince us that this is not your real life. This material existence you are suffering, why you should suffer? Your mind comes. That's why God Jesus Christ, he also told that I am the Son of God. He is happy. So, everyone, you can become similarly happy as soon as you are reinstated in your position. The whole Bhagavad Gita is meant for convincing the conditioned soul. We are conditioned. Awkward circumstances, we are always conditioned. We are not free. Some condition is there. Either state condition or nature condition or a condition led by other living entity or condition laid down by my own body. So we are always in condition. So the Lord says, Krishna says, Ajoti, Sannabhyatma. Although I have no business to come down here, and I am eternal, both of us, Lord and the living entity, both of us are eternal. Bhutanam Isharopi Sam, Ishara. Why? He comes, when Lord comes, he comes out of his goodwill. And when we come, we are forced. We have been forced to accept this body and the condition of the material nature. So, when Lord comes, or his representative comes, they do not accept the condition of the material nature. That is the distinction between ordinary living entity and the Supreme Lord or his representative. That's why Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. So he could not be crucified. It is a false notion. There was a resurrection. Because God or God's representative, they are not under the laws of this material nature. So that's a very wide subject matter, which I'm glad you understand. As we met Prabhupada in the Bhagavad Gita. So Krishna says that although I am the Lord of everything, still I assume this incarnation and I come. Pratim Sama. So the difference is the Pratim Sama Vishara. Prakriti. Prakriti means nature. Now we have got this body offered by the material nature. In the seventh chapter you find that God has two kinds of nature. One is called lower nature. One is called the lower nature and the other is called the higher nature. That thing will be very nicely analyzed in the seventh chapter, when you go to the seventh chapter. Now we are in the beginning of the fourth chapter. So, this Lord has two kinds of nature. One is called lower nature, another is called higher nature, or superior nature, or inferior nature. This nature, this material nature, is inferior nature. And beyond this inferior nature, there is superior nature. And how superior inferior is calculated? The Jaya Idam Dharjate Jagat Jiva Bhuta Mahabaho. It is analyzed like this, that all this material nature, I mean to say, earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and ego, these eight kinds of material nature there, and they have been described as apara. Apara means inferior. And beyond this eighth nature, there is a ninth nature. And which is that? The Jiva Bhuta Mahabaha, this living entity, that is the living form. The living force that is superior nature. And this matter is inferior nature. And the whole world is moving due to the superior nature, not the inferior nature. Just like this tape recorder. There was some difficulty in rhyming on. So as soon as some superior nature, some living entity comes and touches it, it goes on. Although the machine is all right, so unless there is touch of the superior nature, it cannot work. You have manufactured many wonderful machines. You have manufactured this Sputnik, flying the outer space. But do you know that in spite of all wonderful mechanical arrangement of a Sputnik or any machine, can it go on without any touch of a man? No. Unless the man in the laboratory touches the switch of electronic machine, the Sputnik cannot fly in the space. That is not possible. Therefore, however wonderful may be this Sputnik machine, unless there is touch of the living form, it cannot work. So that is the distinction between superior nature and inferior nature. You can understand. Now, we are now in contact with inferior nature. That is our conditional life. We are also, we actually, as spirit soul, we belong to the superior nature. Just like God is superior nature. Prakritim Shyamadhishtha. The Lord says that I incarnate myself in my superior nature. Shyamadhishtha. But what is our position? Although we belong to the superior nature, we have come to this material world not in superior nature, but we are in contact with the inferior nature. Therefore, death takes place. Our birth and death is due to the body. The body is subject to the annihilation at a certain period, and that we accept as death. And similarly, when we accept another body and come out of the mother's womb to work here, then we call it birth. And when we give up that body and go away to take another body, that we call death. So this birth and death is due to this inferior nature. So here, Lord Krishna says that when I come, I do not come in this inferior nature. It is a great mistake if somebody thinks that Krishna or Krishna's representative, just like Bona Fide Pandit, Jesus Christ or other great leaders of the religious faith, they do not come with the inferior nature. They come with the superior nature of body. That you have to accept. If you have to accept the soul explained in the Bhagavad Gita, then we must accept that God and His representative, they do not come. Those who come directly from the kingdom of God, they do not come accepting this inferior nature. Now, the question may be, why God and His representatives do come? They are in superior nature, they are in the eternal kingdom, why do they bother themselves to come here? Why do they bother themselves to come here? This question may be raised. As soon as we hear that God and His representatives come, so let's question, why do they come? Because we are We do not know that they come to reclaim us. Therefore, our question is, why do they come? And here the answer is, yada yada hi dharmasya jnani bhavati bharata abhyuttanam dharmasya tadatmanam siyamaham paritranam sadhunam vinasaya cha dushkritam dharma samasthapanarthaya dhammamami yuge yuge. Now this is the mission. Mission of the Lord and His representative. What is that mission? Jada jada hi dharmasya jnani bhavati. Whenever there is decline of the principle of life, now it is here stated dharma. Dharma is translated in English as religion. But religion is meant just like a kind of faith. Just like I am Hindu. I am Hindu means I have got faith in the Hindu system of religious function. You are Christian. That means you have faith in the Christian system of religious function. So religion, so far as Hindu system is concerned, it is described as a matter of faith. But the word dharma, it is not exactly the same meaning. Faith. Faith in my change. Suppose I am Hindu today. Now I can embrace tomorrow a Christian. Or you are Christian, you can become a Hindu. There are so many changes. People are free to accept one faith and give up another faith that is going on. But dharma does not mean that faith which can be changed. Dharma is a thing which cannot be changed. That means there is something in you, in me, and everyone that is called dharma. That is called, that cannot be changed. And what is that? This is a very fine analysis of human nature. When you analyze the human nature, you will find that one thing there is, which is called rendering of service to others. Suppose I am a Hindu. Now I am doing something. I am rendering my service to my family, to my country, to my boss, or to others. Without rendering service, nobody can exist. We are all exchanging simply service. I am rendering service to somebody, somebody is rendering service to me. So whole world is existing under this system, rendering service. Your President Johnson, he is supposed to be the chief man of your state, but still he is rendering service. What is he doing? He is rendering service to the people. So he has the same business as you are rendering service to your boss and taking some money. Then again, with the money you are serving your family. So this service, suppose I am now Hindu, I become a Christian, a Mohammedan, that my real business of rendering service does not change. So dharma means which you cannot change. Just like there are many examples in natural objects, just like water. Water is liquid. It is not a fact, it is a fact. Water is liquid. You cannot say that water is liquid and if it changes its state, then it can become solid. No. Liquidity of water cannot be changed. Whenever there is conception of water, if I am blind, suppose somebody gives me, takes here a glass of water, I know it is liquid. So as the liquidity of water cannot be changed, now as soon as I speak of fire, so you understand fire is hot. Now, if you can you change that fire becomes cold and still it is fire? No. As so long it is fire, it is hot. So long it is water, it is liquid. Similarly, everything you analyze, take for example chili, red pepper. Oh, it is very hot. Now when you take chili from the market, you see how much, what is the degree of its hotness. If it is very hot, oh, it is very good chili. If you find a chili sweet like sugar, you reject it, oh, this is not good. Because that is the religion of the chili, to become very hot. Similarly, sugar, if you take sugar, if it is very hot, no, it is nonsense. I want sweet. So, in everything, if you analyze, you find a particular quality. That is the religion. That is the religion. So we are living entities. Forget yourself that you are Christian and Hindu, Islam, Muslim, and Buddhist. Forget yourself. I am living entities. When we come to this point, that is called liberation. That is called liberation. Sarvapadhi Vilin Mukta. When we become free from all these designations, that is called liberation. Liberation means nothing more. The conception of getting free from this designation which we have acquired from the association of material means. That is called designation. Because I have got a particular body, therefore I have got so many designations. I call myself a man or animal, or I have got some name given by my parents, or because I am born in some particular country, I designate myself to belong to that country, and because I accept some particular faith, so I designate myself to that faith in so many ways. We are now designated. The designation should be given. When designations are given, then we are free, pure soul. In that pure soul, the religion is to serve the Supreme. That's like in a machine, you find a big machine. There are thousands of parts in the machine, but it is a small part. They are all giving service to the whole machine. That's like your body is a machine. So, you have got your finger. Now, what is the function of the finger? What is the religion of the finger? The religion of the finger is to give service to the body. Just like I am giving service this way, sometimes this way. So, this part of this body is meant for giving service to the whole body. Similarly, we are part and parcel of the Supreme. So our business is to give service. That service is now being rendered, actually. We are also serving now, but serving in designation. I'm serving, I'm not a master here. That is foolishness. Just like I told you, even if President Johnson is not a master, he's also serving. Every one of us is a servant. But what kind of servant? Oh, I'm servant of my wife. I am servant of my family, I am servant of my country, I am servant of my society. And if there is nothing, then I am servant of my cat, and servant of my dog, and servant of my soul. If anybody I see in your country, there are so many gentlemen, they are very fond of becoming servant of cats and dogs. They are no children, but they are voluntarily become servant of cats and dogs. Because that attitude is there. You cannot avoid it. If you have nothing to serve, your wife, your children, then you have to catch them, cat and dog and eat them. That is your nature. You cannot avoid it. So that is your religion. So thanks. Now, our whole thing is to serve the Supreme. That our now designated service. We are now in designated service. That means we, because due to this material warning, we have manufactured so many services. Services we cannot, just like the water cannot be more than a liquid thing. Similarly, we cannot be more than a servant. But because we have got so many designations, our service is being rendered in designation. That is different. Now, when it becomes free from the designation, and we come to our senses and render service to the Lord, that is our position of freedom. Real position. Real position. So, here, Lord says, Jadajadahi dharmasya glani bhavati. Jadajadahi dharmasya glani bhavati means that whenever there is some discrepancy in the modes of rendering service of the living entity. Dharmasya glani bhavati. Dharmasya means, I have explained to you, dharma is my real nature. Dharma means my real nature. Dharma is not a state. Dharma is not a designated state. Dharma is my real nature. So when the real nature of the living entity are geopardite, then at that time, to make the adjustment of the Lord comes. Jalagrahi dharmasya glani bhavati. And Ubhuthanam, whenever there is some discrepancy in the natural sequence and natural life of the human being, and then artificial increase of sense gratification, at that time, when there is too much sense gratification, just like Lord Buddha, when did he appear? He appeared in India. The condition of his appearance, perhaps you know, I shall still explain. When India was too much busy in animal slaughter. Of course, the Hindus, there are basic principles. Animal slaughter. They are, just like in Mohammedans also, they have got some principle for animal slaughter. You know, those who have read Quran, the Mohammedan religion allows animal slaughtering once in a year, which is called Qurban, and they can slaughter animals in the mosque. Similarly, in the basic religion also, the animals are allowed to be slaughtered in some sacrifice. But no religion, either Mohammedan or Hindu, I do not know in detail of the Christian religion, but they do not allow animal slaughter in the slaughterhouse. There are some particular rules and regulations. Anyway, that is a religious reason. But when India was too much addicted for animal slaughtering under the plea of being sacrificed, the Lord Buddha appeared. Why? They misused the basic injunction. They misused the injunction of the basic. So he proclaimed, no, this animal slaughter should be stopped. He did not agree with the basic injunction. Therefore, Lord Buddha's preaching was not accepted. It was once it was accepted, the whole of India accepted. Under the king, under the emperor or so, the whole of India became Buddhist. But later on, Shankaracharya appeared and he met against the Vedantis. So India, Buddhist religion from India was practically banished. So these are historical facts. The real fact is that as soon as the natural sequence of living entity is geopardite, at that time, non-religious principle, unnatural life becomes prominent and people become embarrassed. At that time, the incarnation of Lord is appears. Yadadadahi dharmasya granim bhavati bhāra. Whenever there is discrepancy in the natural life, that is extends you. Religion means the natural sequence of life. When there is some discrepancy in that natural sequence of life, and there is artificial way of life, at that time the Lord or His representative comes either as incarnation or the representative of God. That is the rule. Yadadadahi dharmasya granim bhavati bhāra. And abhuthāna adharmasya, unnatural life. When the tomb is addicted to unnatural life, at that time the law of death is appeared. Why? It is necessary for its pranayama sadhana. Always you know there is always a class of men who are always God-fearing. There may be the percentage of such persons very small, but you will find that is the way of nature. There will be some persons who are devoted to God. They are called sadhu. 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 Sadhu means sadhu description is that. Sadhu means faith or saint. Who is a saint, who is a sadhu? That description is given. Titiksava karunika. Titiksava karunika suita sarvabhutana ajata sattva shanta sadhava sadhu bhushana. This is the definition of sadhu. Saint. Who is a saint? A saint is God who is very tolerant. Tolerant. Tolerant to the utmost. You have got very good example of Lord Jesus Christ, a great saint of sadhu, you are supposed, more than sadhu. Now, just see his behavior, how much tolerant you are. You are being crucified and you are praying God, O Lord, forgive these people who are there here. This is the significance of sadhu. Titiksava karunika. For their personal sake, they are always very tolerant, but they are very kind to all people, all living entities. Very kind. In spite of their all disadvantages, they try to give something, real knowledge to the people in general. Karunika. And Sridhar Sarvabhutanam. And a sadhu is not a friend of a particular class, particular community, or particular country. No. A sadhu, a saint is he who is friend of all, not only of human beings, even of animals and less than animals. These are the qualifications of sadhu. Ajata sattrava, and they have no enemy. They are not anyone's enemy, everyone's friend. Enemy of course, even the greatest man will find some enemy. This is the nature of this world. Even the most perfect man will have some enemy. So, that is the one thing. But this sadhu, this saint, is no one's enemy. He is friend of enemy. Titiksava karmika sridha sarvabhutana ajata sattrava shanta. They are nobody's enemy. And shanta, or a peaceful. These are the qualifications of sadhu. Now here, the Lord says that I come, or my representative comes. What? Paritranaya sadhunam. Sadhunam. The Lord is very much anxious for the saintly person who has sacrificed everything for the service of the Lord. They are very, very dear to the Lord. Lord cannot tolerate any insult or any misbehavior to a sadhu. Also sadhu, they do not have themselves mind in their insults. They do not mind. But the Lord will never tolerate if a public. Just like a small boy, your child, if somebody slaps him in the street, that boy may excuse, all right. But his father or mother will never tolerate, why not slap my son? That is me. Similarly, this sadhu, who is a great devotee of the law, be mildly tolerant, he can crucify, he can do any misdeed again. He is never angry. But God will never tolerate. We must always remember that. He has got special protection, special vision on the sadhu. You'll find in the Bhagavad Gita. Samoham sarvabhuta, samoham sarvabhuteshu, nami deshasina priya. The Lord says, I am equal to everyone. Otherwise, how is any God? He is equal to everyone, yes. I am equal to everyone. Nobody is my enemy and nobody is my friend. Samoham sarvabhuteshu, nami deshasina priya. Nobody is my enemy, nobody is my friend. I am equal to everyone. But Jesu Bhajanti Mayam Sitya, Teshu Teshu. But anyone who is devoted to me, I have got particular attention for him. Although he is neutral, it's still the person who is devoted is always thinking of Krishna, Krishna content. There is special protection, special. Therefore, Lord Krishna declares, he is trying to go with Kaunteya Pratijanihi, Nami Vastat Pranashyati. My dear Kaunteya, Arjuna, you can declare it to the world that my devotee will never vanquish. Never he vanquish. So here, the same thing is said. What is the mission of God? Why does he come down? Now, that is explained here. He says, Paritrana Sadhuna. I come down, I invite myself, or I send my representative only for the protection of the sense persons, and vinashaya to duskritam, of those who are miscreants, just so, are finished. The Lord Krishna's mission was two things, paritrana sadhanam vinashaya to duskritam. He wanted to study Arjuna, the five brothers, the most pious and devoted and kshatriya, he wanted to establish them for ruling over this world and he wanted to vanquish the party of Arjuna. That was his mission. Two things. Paritrana sadhanam vinashaya cha dushkrita. Dushkrita not dharma samasthapanarthaya. And another mission is to establish what is real religion. What is religion? In the name of religion, so many things are going on. But the real religion is that we must know that our natural function is to render service to the Lord. That is real religion. And forgetting this principle of life under designation of this matter, I am serving, giving my service to so many things. That means because I am naturally, now just like you said the knife. Now what is the function of knife? Knife function is to cut. You can cut a pencil and you can cut your throat. The function of the knife is nothing but when you cut a throat, then the knife becomes polluted. But when you... The function of the living entity, the original natural function is to render service. And when the service is misused, it is rendered where the service should not be rendered. When it is misused, that is called dharmasya glani. That means discrepancy in the natural function of human life. So, when Lord comes, he has three functions. He gives protection to the saintly person. He vanquishes the irresponsible and irreligious or demonic person. And he establishes the real religion. Real religion. Dharma Sanskarna Kaya, Samhwani Yuge Yuge. He comes down not only once, but he comes down many times. Because this material world is such. Now suppose an adjustment is made, then again some after some time it will deteriorate. Just like there was such one. There was some armistice and some arrangement was made between Germany and the other party. Then again the second war is there. And again preparation is going on for the third war. You see? So this is world is like that. Even if you make a very good arrangement, it will gradually deteriorate. This is the function of the time. Follow. That's like you build a very nice house. Then after 50 years, it deteriorates. And after 100 years, it more deteriorates. Take for example your body. When it was newly born, when I was a child, a very good looking child, everyone is kissing and everyone is what? Now I am becoming old and nobody cares. So this is the function of this material nature. Even if you make a very good adjustment, gradually it will glide down to the lowest state. Therefore, it requires a periodical adjustment. For that reason, the Supreme Lord or the Supreme comes. That is explained. Yes. The Puritranaya Sadhana Vinashaya to Vishkita. For protecting the saintly person and for vanquishing the unfaithful, unbeliever, and for establishing the real function of the living entity, Dharma Sanskapana, Sambhavani Jivijiya. I come down not only once, but many times, in many millenniums, Lord Krishna. Thank you very much. Now we can ask any questions.